Hey guys, as recording, so
flat earth
boy, that's the topic at hand. It's like crazy mode.
So that, does that mean the woman that got a flat ass? You know, since they say the woman earth and
the mother earth.
right. That's a flat ass woman.
Woman is the earth, mother earth. She's the mother of us all, the queen of the Israelite queen.
That's amazing shit, man.
Look, I think that trash bag will work.
What?
Check that out. Can you see yourself? Rain, sleet, hell or snow, we ain't stopping. Check it out. Is that good? That shit still don't seem right.
It was good at first.
Was it? There we go.
I don't really need it right now. That's why you just cover up our bags, man. This ain't raining that bad, though.
Yeah, we're getting lucky right now. We are.
Because it was just pouring right before we came out here.
Sure the fuck was.
It was. I couldn't even see driving on the freeway.
Fuck yeah.
Motherfuckers driving on.
I miss some people driving on from the
road. Yeah, can't see shit. Hey, it's all crazy. You have a boss, show me how a shot. What's this crazy ass shit down here? They got a, look at this, got a truck. I don't know if I'm even getting it. They got a truck with a big ass screen on the side of it. You see that?
And one just went by.
Where'd that shit go?
Yeah, they're gonna be, you gonna see them all day today. Well, just televised too. Whatever's going on here with the college is televised.
That's a big ass LCD screen on the side of a truck. There's some kind of primary shit going on up here, right?
That's it.
Yeah, because the elections is Tuesday. The primaries?
Primaries.
It's Tuesday.
And they're making a big deal out of that shit, too.
I'm tired of hearing about it.
You know, I can't turn the TV now.
Yeah, because I like radio. I don't even listen to the radio no more right now.
Oh, you hearing, man.
I'm tired of hearing about the fucking Republicans and Democrats and goddamn Muslims. That's all they talk about.
That's some shit on there.
I don't hear that bullshit. Oh, God, shoot. Let's get into this. Hey, let's start off with that Deuteronomy 4, since we just talked about it. Let's start from the top. Mm-hmm. That feels good out here now, don't it? On with it. There's some doo-doo rags over here, man. Some actual doo-doo rags. God just started the top.
Now therefore, hearken, O Israel, to the statutes which I teach you, which you do them, that you may live and go in and possess the land which Yahweh God and your fathers given you.
Right, because this is the book of Deuteronomy, so this is Moses talking to the children of Israel, us, and this has happened, this is all he's saying right after they came out the Exodus, you know what I'm saying, right out of Egypt, and they out in the wilderness. Go ahead.
You shall not add unto the word which I command you, neither shall you diminish from it, that you may keep the commandments of Yahweh your God, which I command you.
Yeah, so you're not supposed to be teaching no new shit that you wasn't already taught by the prophets and the elders, you know what I mean? Because, you know, that's what Jake loves, to add some new shit to the doctrine, you know what I mean? Keep going.
Your eyes have seen what Yahweh did because of Baal Peor.
Be at Baal Peor.
For all the men that follow Baal Peor, Yahweh thy God hath destroyed them from among thee. But he that did believe unto Yahweh your God are alive, every one of them this day. Behold, I have taught you statutes and judgment, even as Yahweh my God commanded me, that you should do so in the land whither you go to possess it.
Go ahead, keep going.
Speak therefore and do them, for this is your wisdom and your understanding in the sight of the nations.
Yeah, so this is all wisdom and understanding. is his Bible, the Holy Bible, which is the greatest treasure on the planet Earth. You know what I'm saying? It's the most valuable treasure on the planet. Keep going.
Which I hear all these statues that say, surely this great nation is a wise and understanding nation.
Right. Yeah, you want to be able to tell that by looking at two-thirds of it. Most of our people, they got no wisdom and understanding because they forsake the knowledge of the Most High. You know what I'm saying? The commandments of the Most High. These commandments are marvelous. They protect you. Like you look at the commandments like pork. The Bible says don't eat pork, don't eat pig, swine. Why does the Lord say that? You eat pig, you're going to have a heart attack and drop dead. You ever see it when they cook that swine in the frying pan? You'll have grease this goddamn thick left over in the frying pan after they cook it. And all that grease is going straight to your heart and it's going to kill you. Give you heart disease. Plus, it got all kind of maggots and all kind of parasites in it. So the commandments are there for a reason. The Lord said, don't be a faggot. He said, don't commit adultery. So in America, we got more faggots and more adulterers and adulteresses than any time in history. And we also have more sexually transmitted diseases in history. Half the damn country got STDs. And that would not happen if there was no adultery and there was no faggots. So all these laws is there to help keep you safe. You know what I'm saying? To protect you. Keep on. That's why the scriptures say that that word is a light unto my path and a lamp unto my feet. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
What nation is there so great who have God so nigh to them?
Yeah, so what nation, like Israel, is so great that their power, their God is with them, actually right there with them. Because he was with them in the wilderness, wasn't he? Up in the chariot, a cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night. Moses went up and talked to the Most High. Keep going.
As Yahweh our God is in all things that we call upon him for. I gotta read that one.
That's good.
But what nation is there so great and have God so nigh to them? As Yahweh our God is in all things that we call upon him for. For what nation is there so great that have statutes and judgments so righteous as all this law which I set before you this day?
Oh yeah, these are righteous judgments. Like when the Bible says that you're not allowed to charge your brother usury or interest. That's to protect your brother so you don't turn him into a debt slave. You know what I mean? But in America, it's ran by what? The principle of debt and usury. You can't get a credit card without having to pay interest. Now, if you laid on a bill, you gotta pay interest. Everything's dealing with interest. Keep going. There you go.
Only take heed to thyself and keep thyself diligently, lest thou forget the things which thine eyes have seen, lest they depart from thy heart all the days of thy life. But teach them thy sons and thy sons' sons, especially the day that thou stoodest before Yahweh thy God in Horeb, when Yahweh said unto me, gather me the people together, and I will make them hear my words, that they may learn to fear me all the days that they shall live upon the earth, and that they may teach their children.
Yeah, so you're supposed to be teaching your children the Bible, okay? You're not supposed to be shipping your children off to them government-ran schools. Because right now, you ain't got a choice, though. If you don't send your children to these government-ran schools, what are they going to do? They're going to lock you up. You know, so what kind of sick shit is that? You take your little children, the government snatches your children away from you at what, age 5? And they ship them off, take them away from the parents all day, early in the morning. You got to wake up at a crack of dawn, get shipped off to have some strangers that you've never met in your life teach you. That's wicked and evil. And then they tell you there's no Bibles allowed in the school. Watch out, watch the camera, bro.
That's true.
Alright, so even my son just told me. My son just told me that last week they was teaching him about Greek gods and goddesses in school. You know what I mean? But why won't they teach you the Bible? And then they'll tell you, you know, people say the Bible's fantasy, is mythology. Well, if it's mythology and fantasy, why don't they put it in the fantasy section of school with the Greek mythology? Why don't they do that? Because these fools out here don't understand that those Greek gods like Zeus, that the elite worship those gods. That's why they have Greek fraternities up here on these college campuses, where they sing hymns to Zeus and Apollo and shit. Keep going with that.
And ye shall come near his day, and ye came near and stood under the mountain, and the mountain burned with fire into the midst of heaven. Darkness clouds and thick darkness.
Now that's talking about Mount Sinai. That's talking about the Lord's chariot. So the Most High was flying around in a chariot, what they call a UFO, parked right on top of Mount Sinai. And that's what that's talking about. You can read more about that in what, Exodus 19 and Exodus 20. Keep going.
Now it's that. Go to me out of the mouth, out of the midst of fire. You heard the voice of the words. You saw no similitude. Only you heard a voice. You declared unto you his covenant, which he commanded you to perform, even 10 commandments, and he wrote them down upon 2 tablets of stone.
Yeah, right. The 10 commandments. That's what it's referencing. Exodus 20. That's when the Most High himself uttered the laws and told Israel himself to keep these commandments. And those are the most important commandments. What? You know what I'm saying? Don't kill. Don't steal. Don't be an adulterer. Don't cover your neighbor's property. Don't have other gods. You know, nobody out here in America is keeping the 10 commandments. You know, it's not even illegal to break the 10 commandments in America. You know, you can break the 10 commandments in America and there's no punishment for it. Well, you get punished for what? Killing, maybe. And maybe if you steal something, you'll go to jail. But that's it. What, they keep 2 commandments? They don't keep the Sabbath. You're allowed to be an adulterer. Actually, being committing an adultery, that shit's encouraged in America. You can worship whatever god you want, have all the idols you want. And it's also encouraged to cover your neighbor's property. Everybody, you know, lusting after everybody else's shit. You gotta keep up with the Joneses. Hey, they'll just come and rob you. They like your shoes, they'll just rob you and take them. Like them Jordans. What's them one Jordan? The Jordan 1s or whatever? Go ahead. You know, because I was just watching a video, you know, you get every time some of them new Jordans come out, people say you get shot for them.
Yeah, didn't that just happen the other day?
Yeah.
Yesterday, 2 days ago.
I seen something like that, yeah. I was watching a video on it.
Yeah, they shut the whole fucking mall down in one place.
And then more than that?
Fucking true.
Yeah, keep going.
And thou commanded me at that time to teach you statutes and judgment, that you might build them in the land where you go over to possess it. Take ye therefore good heed unto yourselves, for ye saw no manner of substitute on that day of your house fat unto you in Hebron.
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 Hold on,
we're
talking about
Horeb,
Mount
Horeb. That's the Mount Horeb. Out of the midst of fire, corrupt yourselves and make you as a graven image, the substitute of any figure, the likeness of male or female.
The likeness of male or female. Now this is going into them idols, like the ancient Egyptians worship. Because contrary to what, you got a lot of fools on YouTube talking about, you know, all the truth was in Egypt, all the ancient mysteries and secrets and knowledge is in Egypt. There's no ancient, there's no knowledge or secrets in the worshiping an idol, okay? Worshiping cats and dogs and crocodiles and falcons. How is that knowledge? You worship a falcon? How dumb is that? So read it, it's about to get into it.
Likeness of any beast that is on the earth, and the likeness of any winged fowl that flies in the air.
That's Horus, that winged fowl. That's a likeness of that idol. Keep going.
The likeness of anything that creepeth upon the ground. The likeness of
a dung beetle. Yeah, that creep on the ground, don't it? The Egyptians gave reverence to a dung beetle, a beetle that rolled up shit, took turds and rolled it up. And you know what some dude tried to say? I asked him if he worshiped the dung beetle and piles of shit. And this Egyptian dude, and he told me that, oh, but they rolled the dung up according to the course of the galaxy, the spiral of the galaxy, son. And they really believe that shit. That's some ghetto wisdom. And then you got people who try to say, oh, the Bible's an Egyptian book. But the Bible curses out the Egyptians left and right. That don't make no sense. I'll go ahead.
This was Solomon 14 and 11. Therefore, even upon the idols of the Gentiles shall there be a visitation, because in the creature of the Most High they are become an abomination and stumbling blocks to the souls of men.
Oh, the stumbling blocks. I saw them commit, the commit people, the Egyptologists. That Egypt is a big stumbling block, you know what I'm saying? People think they Egyptian. They crazy.
What y'all down here, getting down with that voting stuff?
They feel the burn.
And they stumbling blocks to the souls of men and they snare to the feet of the unwise.
Yeah, the unwise, all them Egyptologists, they all unwise. Like them dudes you see on YouTube, like Sarah Sukasetti and what's some Polite, what's some other dude's name?
Right.
Yeah, Sarnetter. They all tell the Egyptology. They got no wisdom, no knowledge.
That's what that bullshit flat earth shit is. That's Egyptology.
Oh yeah, it really is. Cause Egypt, yeah, that's a good point. Cause the Egyptology teaches that the sun, when the sun went down every night, that the sun went down into the underworld. And that's, he was down there with old, the sun goes down there with Osiris. Then it, you know what I'm saying? That's, if they try to say that's where you get the sun set from, you know, that's some madness.
Right.
Well, you're right, that flat earth is Egyptology. Because, you know, if the sun goes down to the underworld, then how come I could pull my friend up in Japan when it's night over here to be daytime over there? Shouldn't the sun be down up in the underworld? Where does it go? If it's a flat earth, where does the sun go? That doesn't make no sense. What do you think about it?
Because in the creature of the Most High, they are become an abomination and a stumbling block to the souls of man and a snare to the feet of the unwise. For the devising of idols was the beginning of spiritual fornication.
Yeah, because like them ancient Egyptians, that all ancient Egypt was nothing but idol worship. And then they built giant idols of the Pharaoh. And I mean, you've seen those giant statues of the Pharaoh. And then the Pharaoh commanded the people to worship him and that he was a god. He declared that he was God. He was Horus in the flesh. So that the Egyptians, they were tyrants. Go ahead.
And the devising of idols was the beginning of spiritual fornication and the invention of them, the corruption of life. For neither were they from the beginning, neither shall they be forever.
That's all ancient Egypt was nothing but idol worship, idolatry. But our people, they get caught up to that very easily, because our people are simple. They got no sense. Did you get tired of hearing that Egypt shit, man? And then you got the New Age movement too. You know, all these New Age motherfuckers talking all that bullshit. Oh, that's my dude. I know that guy. We should get him over here.
That dude right there?
Huh?
That dude right there?
Yeah. Go ahead. Huh? Pow!
Man.
What's up, bro? Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Why, you was protesting?
Nope. Yeah,
oh, really? Well, hey, well, Bernie Sanders is a Jew. Bernie Sanders is a Jew. With Jews, you lose. Go ahead.
It's Proverbs 14 and 15. The simple believeth every word, but the prudent man looketh well to his going. A wise man feareth and departeth from evil, but the fool raggeth greatly, and is confident. He that is soon angry dealeth foolishly, and a man that wickedly entices his understanding. The simple inherit folly, and the prudent man understands.
Oh yeah, that is the simple's inheritance is folly. Because they simple ass mom and dad taught us some simple ass shit, and they repeated that shit.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Same shit.
Just pure vanity. Talking about some bullshit. Because everything we've been taught our whole life is a lie.
That's what they're going to vomit that shit right back in the world.
That's what they do. Go ahead, bring it up.
Proverbs 15:21. Folly is joy to them that is destitute of wisdom, but a man of understanding walketh upright.
Read that again.
This folly is joy to them that is destitute of wisdom.
Yeah, destitute of wisdom. That's our people, ain't it? They destitute of wisdom. They don't know a goddamn thing about nothing. Oh, like that dude. Last week we was teaching at the park. Some dude came up against us. He said, what kind of Bible you got? We was like, we got a King James. He's like, but that ain't a real Bible though, because that ain't even, you ain't even got the whole Bible. He's like, you gotta have the Old Testament and the New Testament, not no King James. He actually said that. He's so stupid, he didn't know that a King James has an Old and New Testament in it. But he's an expert though, right? And he knows what he's talking about, right? That's our people. That's
some shit he done heard.
It's just madness. I mean, and then you'd be wrong if you just hit him with a brick. You'd be the one, you go to jail. If you stone him with stones, you'd be the one of fault.
Right.
But yeah, I know you can't be hitting people with bricks and center blocks and baseball bats, but that's how you feel. They're so stupid, you just want to knock their goddamn head off. But we can't, we got to stay spiritual. They were really, that clown, what was that, last Tuesday? That motherfucker, man. He was dumb as they get. Oh, the King, that ain't King James, that ain't the Old Testament. You ain't got the Old Testament. Then you got people who take sides with him, like, oh, he knows what he's talking about.
That nigga deep.
Don't know shit from apple butter.
John 8, I'm going to start at 43. Why do you not understand my speech, even because you cannot hear my word? You are of your father, the devil, and the lust of your father you will do. He was a murderer from the beginning, and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh his own. Well, he is a liar in the father of it.
That's really, because that's our people got the spirit of Satan in them, man.
And because I tell you the truth, you believe me not. Which of you conceive of me of sin?
And you see too, I'm sorry to cut you off, but the Lord right there was at John 8, and he was cursing out the scribes and Pharisees who were Israelites. And so he told them that they was of their father the devil.
That's right.
We make a rap video.
Huh?
We didn't make a rap video together. Trying to join the family and shit.
That's right. We have your father together.
Or they with that shit.
That's the house of Saul.
Which of you could keep me of sin? And if I say the truth, why do you not believe me? He that is of God hears God's word. Ye therefore hear them not, because you are not of God.
Exactly. So the reason people can't hear our words, like them clowns last Tuesday, is because they're not of God. The spirit of the Most High is not dealing with them. So they never understand or agree with anything we say. Because they got the spirit of Satan in them. Where did the dude ain't come back? I know that guy. That dude was walking over there with the devil horn. He's fucking some punk rocker. He's bugged out. I thought he was gonna come back. I talked to him. He's alright. He's just part of the world, you know what I mean? When you being part of the world, that's a bad thing. That's a bad place to be. walk around with no light, no truth. Where you at, John 8? You probably know that. I got another one. I got preset. Yeah, bring what up. You got some preset. That's good. That was the point. Do you have something you want to read? Nah, I was about to get that one. The precept. Because he's talking to the scribes and Pharisees in John 8. He said the same thing pretty much in Matthew 23. Matthew 23 and 33. Ye serpents, ye generation of vipers, how can ye escape the damnation of hell? That's talking about those missiles. That's talking, when you look that word up in Greek, it says Gehenna, which means destruction, death, and fire. Alright? Because hell, because this is an English Bible, right? Because hell is a Norse goddess. But the true understanding of that, the damnation of hell, that's that hellfire, those missiles. Because if you ain't right with the Most High, you're going to get consumed by missiles. Ye serpents, ye generation of vipers, how can ye escape the damnation of hell? Wherefore, behold, I send unto you prophets and wise men and scribes, that's us, and some of them ye shall kill and crucify, and some of them ye shall scourge in your synagogues and persecute them from city to city. That goes back to them dude last week. What they was trying to do, they wanted to kill us, remember? We taught them the truth about the Bible. Then they call the cops on us and threaten to kill us. How you threaten to kill us and call the cops at us on us the same time, in the same breath? That's Israel. Israel is wicked as hell. That upon you may come all the righteous blood shed upon the earth, from the blood of righteous Abel unto the blood of Zechariah, son of Barachias, whom ye slew between the temple and the altar. Verily I say unto you, all these things shall come upon this generation. O Jerusalem, Jerusalem. Now Jerusalem, like we all are, this is proof right here that Jerusalem is a people before a place, right? When the Lord said, O Jerusalem, which is talking about Israel. He's talking about a people, not the city. It says, O Jerusalem, Jerusalem, thou that killest the prophets and stonest them which are sent unto thee. How often would I have gathered thy children together, even as a hen gathereth her chickens under her wings, and ye would not. Behold, your house is left unto you desolate. For I say unto you, ye shall not see me henceforth, till ye shall say, blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. That's the point. Our people, they don't want to hear nothing you got to say, man. They want to kill you. That tells you how powerful this Bible is. This word is so powerful that when you teach it, that your own people want to kill you, call the cops on you, they beat the shit out of you. You see, they put the Lord on a cross and crucified him. Said they had no king but Caesar. You seen that last week, we was out there teaching. They wanted to kill us, didn't they? That's not the first time. We have multiple death threats. We get death threats on the internet daily. You know what I mean? People, I'm gonna find out where y'all at. Remember that Muslim dude say he's gonna kill us for blaspheming Muhammad? That's in Israel. Just wicked, they the murderers. Huh?
Dude had a dog sword.
Yeah, what? Dog? Oh, dog sword, yeah. That dude with the Pokemon book bag. He pulled a machete out on us. Or a big ass knife or something.
Oh shit. Actually.
Oh, that one day we was teaching the Bible out on Kroger, out on the west side. And your boy tried, He threw the beer at us. So we had multiple times where people wanted to beat the shit out of us just for teaching them the Bible. We ain't threaten nobody who say we was gonna hurt you or nothing. We just gave you the truth, and that made you want to kill us. What other book in the world is out there that you can read and people want to kill you for it? There ain't no other book. This is it right here.
It's Luke 6:22. Blessed are ye when men shall hate you, and when they shall separate you from the company, they shall reproach you, and cast your name as evil for the Son of Man. Rejoice ye in that day, and leap for joy.
Y'all know the end of America is nigh, right?
And when I hit that one,
oh no.
Get ready to be fuel for the fire.
Rejoice ye in that day, and leap for joy, for behold, your reward is great in heaven. For in the like manner,
yeah, because that's what they did. Hey, read that again at the top, because that, all that loud noise, that's a good scripture. I can't even really hear it.
Luke 6:22. Blessed are ye when men shall hate you.
Blessed are you when men shall hate you. Keep going.
And when they shall separate you from their company, they shall reproach you and cast out your name as evil for the Son of Man's sake.
For the Son, because that's what the Son of Man, who's the Son of Man? That's Yahweh Shai. That's the Son of the Most High. So we out here for his sake. You know what I'm saying? But there's no other so-called, like all these so-called religions of the world, from Buddhism to Hinduism, Muslims or whatever. You can say that you a Hindu or Buddhist, and nobody will, they'll think that's cool and interesting. They're like, oh, tell me more about it. But if you tell people you believe in a Bible, they look at you, they'll spit on you. You know what I'm saying? You're like lower than dirt. Go ahead.
Rejoice in that day and leap for joy, for behold, your reward is great heaven.
So we, yeah, that's what we searching for that reward. That's our hope. Go ahead.
For in a like manner, with the fathers into the prophets. 6:26. Once you eat with all men shall speak well of you, and so did their fathers to the false prophets.
He said, woe unto you. Hey, that's a good point. Hey, woe unto you when men speak well of you. Like all these preachers and the pastors in the church. Because anytime we teach someone the Bible, they'll be like, that's not what my pastor said. Like, yeah, pastor's a faggot and a bitch. The Lord's going to kill him. Deal with that. John 7:7. The world cannot hate you, but me it hateth, because I testify of it that the works thereof are evil. Because people, they don't like to be called out on their wickedness. You know what I mean? It cuts their spirit up. When you call someone out on the wickedness, you know, it arouses spirits up inside of them. Then they can't control themselves. Fuck them. As long as they don't touch it. I don't have to clothesline nobody. It's like that. But yeah, you're going to create a lot of enemies teaching the truth though, man. Especially when you teach it the right way. When you teaching that the Lord came to save Israel and all the other heathens are going to slavery. Then people are especially going to hate you then. You got any more? You got to keep the scripture coming like a Gatling gun. I got precepts.
What?
See,
passing over here.
I got some food. Hold on, I'm fine. What is that? John 17? Is that John 16 or 15? It is a script I was looking for. I forget where it's at. Go ahead, bring it out.
Hebrews 11:36. And others had drowned of cruel mocking and scorning.
Oh yeah, hey, what's that? Hebrews 11, right?
Yeah.
Because you said that whole, what, the whole chapter of Hebrews 11 is dealing with the concept of faith, something most people ain't got. But just to give you an idea where this is coming from, is this is talking about the prophets. Let me see that real quick. No, oh, my fault. I'm all messed up. Yeah, because you got to read the whole chapter to get a full understanding. You got to start right there.
Moreover, abounds in imprisonments, there was stone asunder.
Now, this is talking about the prophets. It said because they had great faith, they was doing the work without fear. And because of it, they got stoned to death, sawed asunder, got their heads sawed off. Go ahead.
Were slain with a sword. They were wounded about in sheepskins. And they wondered about the sheepskins and goatskins being destitute, afflicted, tormented, or if the wall was not worthy. They wandered in deserts and in mountains and in dens and in the caves of the earth. These all, having attained a good report through faith, received not the promise. God had provided some better thing for us, that they taught us would not be made perfect.
All right, so it said that the prophets, they was walking around wearing sheep skins and goat skins. So, because they wasn't walking around wearing nice $300, $400 garments, like Nate and his purple crew, the purple people eaters. Yeah, they all purple. You know, they trying to look all lavish. You got all these Israelites out here. They trying to look all lavish, wearing all these nice, expensive clothes. Talking about they a prophet, a man of the Lord. The prophets wandered about in sheepskins and goatskins, looking destitute. You know what I'm saying? That's why you don't see this coming out here, you know, the expensive garment. Look at my garment. My garment's raggedy as hell. You know what I mean? I say the raggedy the better. That's what Jake always want to look fly. You know, he's always about to impress men rather than the Most High. The same thing with these churches. You go up in any of these churches, if you go up in there dressed like a bum, they're going to kick you out. Or if they don't kick you out, they're going to look down on you. When your mom gets you ready to go to church, you got to wear your Sunday's best. You ain't going to be looking all raggedy. You know what I mean? Dumb-ass women, man. Simple-ass women. And the women, they go... You ain't never gonna see a woman dressed in those sheepskins or goatskins. You ain't no gonna see a woman be a prophet. So these people, they got their shit all fucked up, man. Are we hold this for a second?
I felt disappointed as fuck. I swear I am.
You felt the burn.
I'm fucking disappointed too.
Let me stop. So we ain't on that impressing men shit. That's what most of them Israelite groups out there. Nathaniel 7, the ISUPK. What's some other groups? The GOCC. All the GOCC, they like to dress in all white. You know, pretend like they all righteous. Wearing their fresh, clean white tees. Little faggot shit.
Here we go. This is Ecclesiastes 10 and 2. As a judge of the people is himself, so are his officers, and what manner of man the ruler of the city is. Such are all that they that dwell therein. An unwise king destroyeth his people, but through the prudence of them which are in authority, the city shall be inhabited. You know,
unwise madness. Yeah. Bernie Sanders supporter. Bernie Sanders is a goddamn Jew. The Jews you lose. Hey, read that part again, man. I got distracted by that weirdo.
Three. An unwise...
Again, what?
An unwise king destroyeth his people.
Barack Obama.
Well, I'm getting reference too long.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, the leaders, right?
Yeah, right.
Yeah, you got, yeah.
The motherfuckers throwing it hand in hand.
Yep.
What they call themselves, the authority or the governing body?
Oh, you talking about that, Masharra.
Right, yeah.
Gasharala. Man, those people are a joke.
The governing body of Israel? Look at this one.
Dude, he looked like that turtle off the running a turtle that was racing motherfuckers.
Yeah.
Don't he run like that turtle?
The turtle.
Did he race Bugs Bunny? He got Bugs Bunny try to cheat. He's like doop. He said fucking Esau's a big faggot. It's some nice weather though, actually.
Yeah, like
right now, without the water and shit.
He definitely had mercy on us this year, bro.
But like he was saying, all the leaders, they all, we got these bootlegged Israelites trying to start up their own government. Who's that head? What's the dude, the head of it? I don't know his name. With Peraza with him. That shit's bugged out, man.
These niggas getting around, boy. I can't take them off of the serious.
You can't take them serious. They got them all staying in a formation. And how do you go from being in a military formation to rapping? I mean, how do you get rapping in military formations at the same time? Where they do that at? It's just madness.
Something big is coming for them, man.
And it's gonna be publicized too.
He's gonna made an example of in the public, right?
Yeah, it's gonna
right.
Everybody's gonna see it.
It's gonna be beautiful.
That's how the Lord does it. When you know what I'm saying? When the Lord fucks you up, he does it as an example for others to fear. You know what I mean? What's up?
They was gonna be out here in troops.
Ain't nobody out here, man. Everybody wanted to go see Donald Trump, not Bernie Sanders.
Yeah, sporting event.
Did you see how many people showed up at Dayton Airport? Was that yesterday?
No. Dayton. That's where they landed at.
Well, right by Dayton. It was some airport.
Not Rickenbacker.
It was out by.
Not Rickenbacker. You talking about
Wright Patterson? I don't think it was Wright Patterson though. Somewhere.
Right. I know what you're talking about.
I can't remember the name. They got thousands.
That military base is getting dug in Dayton. There's a military base there. Don't worry.
But you see that? They getting behind your boy Donald Trump, though. They think he gonna be the Messiah. Every 4 years, someone's gonna save you. Man, you people are fucking lost.
This shit picking up steam.
It is picking up steam.
Some motherfuckers are starting to fight.
They starting to fight up in Chicago. You see that?
Yep.
They went nuts up in Chicago. They was going so crazy, they had to cancel the rally. And that makes you think that something wild and crazy is going to happen before the election. You know, big ass right, they going to see, you know, how the race is turning out. Because somebody tried to attack Trump yesterday. They tried to jump up on the stage.
Yeah, they caught him,
So that, and he was sent out there. He was just a little henchman.
Yeah, these are planning this shit. They timing it just right.
Yeah, they
timing it with what's going on over the east.
So they gonna stir up more racial division too. So that's why they keep trying to link up Trump with the KKK and David Duke. Then they had, they keep showing that one video, that white dude, punching that Jake in the face. You see that?
Oh, yeah.
They keep showing that over and over again because they want you to start. They want to start some shit.
It's already started.
It's already started. But they trying to fuel it. They trying to, you know, egg it on. And it's going to be beautiful, man.
It's nice. It's real nice.
It is nice. And then that's when the martial law going to come in and shut everything down. Yeah, that Donald Trump was some entertaining shit, though, man.
I still haven't watched anything on it yet.
You ain't?
Nothing. I can't do it, man.
That shit is hilarious, man.
I just can't do it.
It's like watching Showtime at the Apollo.
Right.
It's just pure comedy.
These motherfuckers actually think it's going to make a difference to get back in office.
Yeah. That shit's been going on for what? Over 200 years now, and they still ain't got it. Every 4 years. And they still ain't figured it out yet.
It's amazing. Stupid people out
there. They're real stupid. They thought Obama was the Messiah, the chosen one. Like your boy Louis Farrakhan said that he was the one, didn't he? And then now he's turning against Obama. How you gonna be the chosen one, the anointed, and then now you against him? Double-minded man. Say Hillary Clinton was up here or something?
Yeah,
or?
She's here with Congress too.
That demon witch bitch. She's evil as hell. Well, you really got not a whole lot of people like Hillary no more though. They all behind that Jew Bernie Sanders. He's a fucking Jew. I mean, what else do you need to know? You know people still don't get Revelation
2:9. Matthew 24:12. And because of iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold.
Yeah, there ain't no love out here. You gotta watch your back when you walk down the street.
Hell yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You can't be keeping large amounts of cash on you. This shit is, we live in the fucking jungle out here, none of the savages.
It's gonna be a lot more.
Yeah, it's going to get a lot worse.
Yeah.
It will get worse before it gets better.
Yeah.
Donald Trump ain't going to make America great again. Oh. When was America ever great to begin with? Do y'all know when that was? Can someone give me a date? You know what I'm saying? A date? Just exactly when and where America was great? Because I missed that one. Did you see that? I didn't see that part. I've been poor my whole life. My whole family has too. My whole life I've heard everybody complain about how shitty this is. And that's how it tells you how stupid people are. Our people are so goddamn stupid, they'll be living in the ghetto, one paycheck away from being homeless. Because you know most people are one paycheck away from being homeless. Government taking all your money, fucking shit up. And they still living in their house is so raggedy, shit falling apart, you know what I mean? Roaches all up in the motherfuckers.
They comfortable.
They got crime, drugs everywhere. They still fly that goddamn American flag in their front yard. See how stupid they are. They are proudly fly that too, boy. They'll even put the American flag on that car and ride down the street with it. And that's a popular thing with Jake now wearing American flag shirts and stuff, you see that? That's real popular now.
2 Kings 15:48.
With Jews, you lose. Bernie Sanders is a Jew. Whatever happened.
I heard he said he'd been wearing this shirt for 2 years.
I thought he said he was a sodomite.
He probably said that too.
Hey, read did you get something?
Second Nephi 15:48. Thou hast followed her that is hated in all her works and in vision. Therefore saith the Most High, I will send plagues upon thee, widowhood, poverty, famine, sword, pestilence, to waste thy houses with destruction and death. And the glory of thy power shall be dried up as a flower when the heat shall arise that is sent over thee.
Ain't that what happened to our people though? I mean, it's going to get worse. Like he said, it's going to get worse. We already in poverty, already got pestilences, diseases. It's going to get worse. Because they keep putting their trust in man and not the Most High.
Yeah, trust in Egypt.
Yeah, put trust in Egypt. They trusting in the Egypt. And the American government is pretty much, what is it, derives from Freemasons, created by Freemasons, which goes back to ancient Egypt and ancient Babylon. They call it, what, the ancient Babylonian mystery school. Because really, the president is no different than the pharaoh. That's why he uses the eagle as a symbol. It's like a bird, just like the symbol of the pharaoh is a falcon, Horus. Go ahead.
Thou shalt be weakened as a poor woman with stripes, and as one chastised with wounds, so that the mighty and lover shall not be able to receive thee. Would I with jealousy have so proceeded against thee, said the Lord, if thou hadst not always slain my chosen, exalting the stroke of thine hand, and saying over their dead, when thou wast drunken, set forth the beauty of thy countenance. The reward of thy whoredom shall be in thy bosom, therefore shalt thou receive recompense, like as thou has done unto my chosen, saith the Lord. Even so shall the Most High do unto thee, and shall deliver thee into mischief. Thy children, that's politics shit.
Esau.
That's that mischief shit.
Yeah, that's some mischievous madness.
Right.
Yeah, because we got no business being involved in politics.
No business.
Politics is the biggest waste of time on the earth. It's just it's a rigged system. All the goddamn voting machines are electronic. You know what I'm saying?
Just like we always say about sports. The fix is in. You know?
It should have been rigged. That's how it's always been. Even the president that they claim was good, JFK, they say he was one of the good ones. We know that's a book. But anyway, but they got proof that even he stole the election.
Did he spare $1 for the homeless?
Huh?
Did he spare $1 for the homeless?
Remember one day we see two Jakes walking down the street begging for money and shit. He had a big gigantic bag full of change. Probably a couple $100 in change. That's what he's been getting all day.
Got paid. Thy children shall die of hunger, and thou shalt fall through the sword. Thy cities shall be broken down, and all thine shall perish with the sword in the field. They that be in the mountains shall die of hunger, and eat their own flesh, and drink their own blood. For very hunger of bread and thirst of water. Thou as unhappy shall come through the sea and receive plagues again. And in the passages they shall rush on the idol city and shall destroy some portions of this idol city and shall destroy some portions of thy land and consume part of thy glory and shall return to Babylon that was destroyed. And thou shalt be cast down by them as stubble, and they shall be unto thee as fire, and shall consume thee in thy cities, in thy land, and thy mountains. All thy woods and thy fruitful trees shall they burn up with fire. Thy children shall they carry away captive, and look what thou hast, they shall spoil it, and mar the beauty of thy face. That's it.
But that's what happened to Israel though. In the ancient world, it happened numerous first we went into captivity under the Egyptians, then under the Assyrians, tormented us, then the Babylonians, then the Romans, and now we captivity in America.
All over. Y'all notice that building, that company business shut down that restaurant?
Did it?
Yes, it's been empty.
I didn't know.
Yeah, I just noticed my damn self. And remember, that place is always packed. Remember, people always sitting on the stairs, sitting on the thing?
Yeah, they always be over here smelling swine.
Yep, yep. They be sitting in the window staring over here. Because we was entertainment to them motherfuckers, man.
I just noticed that
bitch is shut down.
All this shit's fucked up back.
That's funny, man. Of all places, this place ain't no business for that place to be shut down, man. This Ohio State campus freaking more business than the motherfucker.
Yeah, there's more people up here than anywhere else in the city.
I hope they're going to see somebody's hair when they're down the street.
What is that?
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's the whole
thing. That's
the
whole line of shit.
Big-time politician.
That's somebody important. What they call it, the primaries?
Yeah, the primaries.
Yeah.
That looks like some wild shit right there. But, you know, if the politicians are so righteous and so loved, why they need so much protection? You know? They're going way down. Well, they turning down there, ain't they? Yeah, they turning down there.
Yeah, they just
turned. They going to that building. They took going to the back entrance.
Yeah.
So fuck these politicians, man.
Know. Maybe they have it at the shopping scenes arena.
Oh, that bet. Yeah,
you know, because that's going to be a big crowd. So shit, serious shit.
Yeah. I didn't even know about it. I know the election is Tuesday, so that makes sense.
Let me find it. Hold up.
I hate the election cycle too, man. Oh, man, it just fucks up all the news.
I know. And look, you better be careful driving, because this is when most tickets are being handed out, man. This is when most people complain about getting pulled over for nothing. This is that time, man.
I've been seeing more cops now than ever. And there's another one. Yeah, I like listen to, you know, I like to listen to Alex Jones sometimes. But I ain't listening to Alex Jones in like a month. Because every time I turn it on, all you hear is Donald Trump, Hillary Clinton.
Man, oh my goodness.
Primary this, Republican that. Tired of hearing that shit, man.
They can't help. They
he's all
slave to the dollar, man. They gotta please the people, man.
Well, they got a lot invested in that politics. Yeah. They think they gonna make changes of politics.
Turn America around.
There ain't no way in hell.
They're gonna turn America around.
We're gonna defeat the New World Order. Man, you ain't gonna defeat shit.
Right.
Your boy LaVoy Finnegan thought he was gonna defeat him too.
This is weird. It's not even lawyers now, man. I've been reading about it all day.
Oh, yeah. Well, check 10TV.
That's what I'm on.
Oh, 10TV.com? It's probably on there somewhere. You know, that's all they're going to be talking about. Hey, what's up, bro? You want to talk? Yeah, another, he's spilling the burn.
March Madness is just starting now.
Oh, yeah.
Soccer, I think, is starting to kick off.
Yeah, I seen it, because Michigan State, I just seen my stepdad was watching that shit. Fucking Michigan State just beat Purdue. College basketball is whack as hell. Everybody goes straight to the NBA.
This ain't no time to be in that shit.
Hell no.
There ain't no time for that shit now, man. Ain't no time for it, man.
All that sports, that's for children anyway, man. Playing with balls. You got grown men all worried about what a another man did with a ball. He's a great man because he can bounce a ball, throw a ball, and put a ball through a hole. I mean, this is real shit.
It took it all off, man. It took it all. I've been reading. I'm telling you, all day I've been reading, man. It's just weird. It took it all off.
I mean, something's going on because something's definitely going on because
that's for sure.
There's another.
That's for sure.
Did you see all these Bernie Sanders fucking zombies walking around? Talking about Field of Burn. Hey, get that Revelation 2 and 9. Because Bernie Sanders is a so-called Jew and he's a communist. So yeah, and he's like an open communist. He tell you he's a socialist. Now you know what the USSR stands for?
USSR.
The United Soviets.
United States Soviet Russia.
Well, the Socialist Soviet. Well, yeah, the Soviet Socialist Republic. Right? And they tell you in their name, USSR, that they're socialists. And they was famous for killing, what, 60 million Christians? They killed more, and people complain about the so-called Jews burning in the Holocaust. Oh, shit, I seen a story in the news the other day. They said the oldest man in the world, was 100, you know, that's a lie, 112-year-old Jew who survived the Holocaust.
Oh, I saw it.
Yeah, I wanted to punch my goddamn computer screen when I seen that.
Oh, goddamn Holocaust.
They always got to throw the Holocaust out. Every Jew that lives, he could be 10 years old, he survived the Holocaust. You know what I'm saying?
That's amazing.
And people eat that Holocaust shit up, man.
What's that song in the picture?
It's some more Bernie Sanders bullshit. Hey, read that.
Who's the hot shit, though?
Bernie Sanders. Bernie Sanders? The Jew? Hey, read Revelation 2 and 9.
Revelation 2 and 9. I know that worse than tribulation and poverty that are rich.
Yeah, I knew it, but you can tell him. Go ahead, read that again.
I know that worse than tribulation and poverty that are rich. I know the blasphemy of them that say they are Jews and are not, or a synagogue of Satan.
So the Bible says, I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan. So automatically you should know that Bernie Sanders is a so-called Jew. You should know not to trust him. Him saying he's a Jew, he's telling you a lie right there.
You know what I'm saying?
He ain't no fucking Jew, he's an Edomite. Ain't nothing Jewish. Hey, a Jew wish. He wished he was a Jew.
Saturday Night Live clowning on
himself. Oh, yeah? Oh, because they probably behind Hillary. You know what I mean? I didn't know anybody still watched that shit.
Saturday Night Live.
I ain't watched
TV right there.
I ain't watched that since the Dana Carvey days, bro. Since Wayne's World and all that shit.
Wayne's World.
That show used to be hot.
Yeah. There ain't no more fags in
there. Hey, yeah, it's all faggot shit, yeah. Weirdo shit now.
Sorry, not fucking wrong.
Yeah, because you know the average retard, you know they don't know nothing about the so-called Jews. They don't realize that the so-called Jews, they control America. They always talk about the bankers, this, bankers, that. But they don't know that the bankers are all so-called Jews. They're all Edomites.
Right.
They don't know that. They don't know, even though they watch all these Hollywood movies, that all the popular, all the directors, the producers, they're all so-called Jews. The so-called Jew owns everything, runs everything.
Until it's taken away.
So that when they think, oh, Bernie Sanders is a Jew, the Jews are good people. They was persecuted by Hitler. They didn't do nothing wrong. People are so fucking stupid, man. They don't know shit.
There you go. This is Ezekiel 36 and 5. Therefore thus saith the Lord, power, surely in the fire of my jealousy have I spoken against the residue of the heathen and against all Idumea.
Against all Idumea, which that's the Greek way of saying Edom, the nation of Edom, the Edomites, which is the children of Satan.
Right.
Go ahead.
Which have appointed my land into their possession with the joy of all their heart.
Because what happened now, you got Jews, they occupying the land of Israel right now. They don't belong over there. They're not real Israelites.
That's right.
If they was real Israelites, how come they had to have the Balfour Declaration and had to go conquer the land to get it?
Fucking letter from the World Child.
Yeah.
Let them live with joy in his heart. With the joy of all their heart, with the spiteful mind to cast it out for a prey.
Yeah, if the so-called Jews was real Jews, I mean, then how come they all come from Poland and Khazaria? No, that doesn't make no sense, man. Go ahead.
Prophesy therefore concerning the land of Israel, and say unto the mountains, and to the hills, to the rivers, and to the valleys, thus saith the Lord Power, behold, I have spoken in my jealousy and in my fury, because ye have borne the shame of the heathen. Therefore thus saith the Lord Power, I have lifted up my hand, surely the heathen that are about you, they shall bear their shame. Because that's funny though.
Yeah.
They're actually identity thieves, man.
Yeah, they are.
No shame in their game. Walk around proud as fuck.
Did you know even back in the ancient world too, the Jews, those fake Jews, the Edomites, they came from Mount Seir, and they inhabited a part of lower Judea up in Hebron. They've been stealing, nothing new under the sun.
Right.
They was trying to steal our land back thousands of years ago. That's what they've been wanting to do the whole time. Because Esau is mad and saddened that he did not get the promise. Just like, what's that, Genesis 27, when Esau wept? Remember when he cried because he didn't get the promise?
Right. Right, bitterly.
Yeah, he cried.
Cried like
I'm going to get that real quick. Let me get that.
Cried like a bitch. You talking about Hebrews?
Genesis 27.
Oh, okay.
I'll get it. Then they deceived the whole world. But you see the world, they waking up to the so-called Judah, them Edomites. As you see over there in Germany, you know how the Angela Merkel, the leader of Germany, president of Germany, whatever, Chancellor
Merkel.
Yeah.
Ugly old bitch.
The whole country, they're waking up to the so-called Jew. Now they getting back to their
headache.
They getting back to their Hitler roots and all that shit.
It's giving her a headache.
Yeah. Oh no, but you got the far right party rising up over there.
Yeah.
So the whole world is turning against these devils.
Yeah.
You got devils turning against devils.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Just the time of that great awakening that Daniel speaks of.
Yep. It is a great awakening.
Everything's coming up.
Oh, we was a teaching at a park last week, and we was arguing with that Simple Jake and his this lady, she had to be a Jake too. Looked like she's probably Irish or something. She just came out to cut out of nowhere and started cursing this dude out. Like, don't you know it was the Jews that took down the towers on 9/11?
Right.
It's like an older lady too. You know what I mean?
Right.
Just somebody you wouldn't even expect that from.
Right, the spirit jumped on
her. She just jumped on. She cursed this dude out. She's like, you don't know nothing. You can watch the video. It's on the channel. She came out, so people know about that, man. The truth is getting out. That's one of the main reasons why you gotta go out and teach his word. Otherwise, the truth ain't gonna get out.
I'm gonna get this one before you get that one on Esau.
Go ahead.
Esau's crying ass.
Oh, you already got it?
Nah, this is another one.
Oh, okay.
This is Hebrews 12
and 16. Oh, yeah, that is a good one.
Lest there be any fornicator or profane person as Esau, who for one morsel of meat sold his birthright. For you know how that afterward, when he would have inherited the blessing, he was rejected, for he found no place of repentance, though he sought it carefully with tears.
Yeah, he was crying because he didn't get the blessing, because Jacob got the blessing, not Esau. That's the perfect scripture for it right there.
But he was only crying because he was worried about the physical shit about
Yeah,
you
the
know?
Physical shit, yep.
The gold, the women,
right.
The power.
That's a good point.
It ain't about the righteousness.
The spirit, just like, yeah, because when Solomon became king, let me get that scripture. I'm going to show you, about to get some... You know, he smelled that chicken. I was just watching Tommy Sotomayor video yesterday.
He ain't dead yet.
But you see that? Nah, the Most High gonna get his ass.
Yeah, he really is.
But he brought out that story to somebody killed him. One Jake killed another Jake over a piece of chicken.
Mm-hmm.
You see that? You never watched Tommy Sotomayor?
Yeah, he got some good shit coming up, though.
Yeah, I mean, but he's really a blasphemer.
Right.
You know, he don't believe in the Most High.
He loves America, too.
Yeah, he loves America. Mm-hmm. He thinks if you work hard and pay taxes, you'll do good.
That's it.
You know, it's some bullshit. And he's always talking about, you know what, he's wicked as hell. Because he's always talking about women getting pregnant and saying, since they ain't got a man, that they should they should stop the pregnancy, meaning have an abortion.
Yeah, he's morally off.
Yeah, he's all fucked up. Because he always, you know, hinting that bitches need to get abortions if they don't have a man. That's wicked as hell, man.
Most I just using him to expose black bitches.
Yep, that's it. He got his purpose.